you all. And my name is Balwinder Singh, and today we are going to learn about the managerial economics. And the section we are dealing with that is the basics of demand, supply and equilibrium. It is a part 8. So if you are not going through the part previous to that, kindly go through that, because all parts in the sequence, and it is very important for one to go in the sequence manner so as he can develop a better understanding about managerial economics. So friend, in this lesson we are starting with the basics, the concept of market. In the concept of market, firstly we need to understand that the market consists of two sections, that is of consumers and producers. Consumer creates demand, whereas the producer creates supply of the commodities that are available in the market. In general, we can say that the market has two sides, that is the demand side and the supply side, which are defined by their respective graphs. So it is very important to understand that the concept of demand and supply to have a better understanding about the market, as well as we need to understand that is the intersection of these two curves, meaning the demand curve and the supply curve. The intersection of them gives us the equilibrium level of the market, whereas the equilibrium level of the market means the price level at which the consumer is ready to purchase and supplier is ready to sell the given commodity at a given quantity. So it is better to understand the concept of market through the detailed explanation of demand and supply individually. So let's start with the demand side. In demand side is ready to purchase and supplier is ready to sell the given commodity at a given quantity. So it is better to understand the concept of market through the detailed explanation of demand and supply individually. So let's start with the demand side. In demand side, we need to understand that the market demand represent with the demand curve, which a graphical representation of the different level of commodities of a commodity, mean different levels of quantity of a commodity which a consumer is ready to purchase. And this quantity basically defined at a different level of prices. In general, we can say that the demand curve represents the different quantity that is to be demanded by a consumer at the different level of prices. And in general, we can say that the price level and the quantity demand has the inverse relationship. It means as the price goes up, the quantities demanded goes down, and price goes down, the quantity demand goes up. So it is a very basic concept of demand side of the market. Now, in addition to that, we need to understand that the aspect of change in demand. Change in demand, basically we have like increase or decrease in demand. increase and decrease in demand basically refers to the condition where the quantity demanded or the demand of a commodity change just because of other factors influencing. Like other influencing factor means if the demand changes due to any other factor other than price level, mean there are many factors like price of the commodity, taste and preferences, market demand like population, income level, substitute good price and so on. I mean there are many other factors, but if the change of a demand changes due to any other factor, I mean other than price, then the demand is to be considered as change in demand. The change in demand, which further can be classified into two categories like increase or decrease in demand. So it is easy to understand, I mean if the demand changes due to other factors, mean the factors other than price, the change is considered as the change in demand, which further explain as increase or decrease in demand. Whenever we have increase or decrease in demand, the demand curve resultantly shift whether to the right hand side or to the left hand side. Here we have the graphical representation of change in demand. As we know, whenever the demand increases, the shift in demand curve is to be placed. So it is better to understand that whenever the increase in demand takes place, that demand curve shifts rightward, whereas whenever the demand decreases, or we may say the decrease in demand curve takes place, that demand curve shifts inward or to the left hand side. So it is very important to understand that is the increase or decrease in demand just because of the other factors, or we may say the factors other than price level that results in increase or decrease in demand curve. Whether the curve shifts to the right side whenever the increase in demand takes place, or to the left side whenever the decrease in demand takes place. So now, we need to understand the second aspect of market, that is the supply side. Supply side of the market represents by the supply curve, which defines that the different level of commodities, mean the quantities of a commodity which a producer is ready to sell. As we know that supply is created by the producer, so whenever the quantity of a commodity is ready to sell by the seller or the producer at different level of prices, that gives us a curve, and the curve is defined as the supply curve. So here we need to understand, whenever the price goes up, the quantities goes high. It means the price and the quantity supplied has a direct relationship. Mean if one increases, the other one also increases with the same or the different proportions. So it is better to understand by the basic aspect that in demand, price and quantity has inverse relationship, whereas in supply, price and quantity has a direct relationship. Now, we need to understand that the same aspect like increase and decrease in supply, as we know that the increase and decrease in demand is just because of the other factors, mean the factor other than price. In the same scenario, we can define the increase and decrease in supply mean when due to any factor influencing supply other than price level of the commodity changes the supply of the commodity, it is considered as the change in supply. Mean whenever the supply changes due to any other factor than price level, then it is considered as change in supply, which further can be of two types, like increase or decrease in supply. The same, it affects the supply curve by a shift, and as the same scenario that the increase in supply shift the curve towards the right side, whereas decrease in the supply curve shift the curve to the left hand side. So the both things are same, mean the right side shift due to the increase and left side shift due to the decrease, whether it's of demand curve and the order supply curve. Now let's discuss about the market equilibrium. Friend, market equilibrium is the very important aspect of the market, because it is the price at which the producer wish to sell and the consumer wish to purchase the commodity. Mean whenever the producer is ready to sell and consumer is ready to purchase the given quantity of a commodity at a given price level, that situation is considered as the market equilibrium. And graphically we can represent this situation wherever the demand curve and the supply curve intersects each other, and it is defined as E, like the equilibrium situation. So whenever the supply and the demand curve intersect each other, that situation is considered as the market equilibrium. Now, there are various aspects of the market by the shift in demand of the supply curve. The very first case we have, like whenever the demand increases, or we may say shift towards the right side, the equilibrium level shift from E to E1, whereas the supply curves remain same. So we can say whenever the increase in demand takes place, the price level slightly increases, but there's a vast increase in the demand side, I mean the quantity side of the equilibrium level of a market. In the second case, if the demand decreases and supply remains same, the equilibrium level shift from E to E1, resultantly the price level minutely decreases, but the quantity of a market equilibrium decreases with a very large point. The third case, wherever increase in supply takes place, we can say increase in supply shifts the supply curves toward the right side, where the demand curves remain same. With the slightly change in the price level, there is a huge change in the quantity side. It is just because that is the increase in the supply of the commodity. So that results the shift in the market equilibrium from E to E1. Whereas in the third case, we find that the decrease in supply curve shifts that supply curve towards the left side, and the demand curves remain same. The equilibrium level shift from E to E1, which shows that the slight change in the price level affects the quantity in the negative aspect with a very big value. So slight change in the price changes the quantity of the market equilibrium with a large number. So these are the four aspects of the market equilibrium with the various shifts, whether in the demand curve or in the supply curve. So I hope this lesson gives you a very good knowledge about the market equilibrium and the basics of demand and supply. Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day. Bye-bye and take care.